Welcome back to the channel, everyone. Michael here yet again, and thank you all for joining me tonight. You know, tonight's film, Tenet, is a movie that initially I did want to see in the theater. But I gave it a little bit of thought, and I remembered that one thing that turned me off about the movie was just how much it was built up, all the hype. Everyone was praising the film before it was released. The entertainment industry was just, you know, lifting Christopher Nolan on a pedestal. I think the hype turned me off, and I just kind of said to myself, I'll just wait until it comes to home video. So, you know, the film's been out on home video for quite some time now, and theaters were closing, and the film really didn't get a big theatrical run. So, I mean, you're talking about a movie with, I believe, a $200 million budget, and it couldn't be placed in all the theaters because of closings. But at any rate, and a lot of people probably wouldn't have went anyway with what was going on. But I was kind of, I was curious about the movie. I'd heard so many things about it. I've heard people say it was boring. I've heard people say it was confusing. I just heard very few people talk about how they enjoyed the movie. I didn't hear a whole lot about that. So I kind of went into it with really low expectations. And it's kind of interesting because it seems like when someone tells you a film is bad and you listen to several people say how bad it is, it sucks, and so on and so forth, you end up, when you watch it, you end up thinking, maybe it's not that bad. It's not as bad as they say because your expectations have been just lowered by so much. And I've experienced that sometimes where you go into a movie that's, you know, maybe lots of people think it's bad, but then you watch it and it just doesn't seem that bad because you're just used to, you're expecting it to be terrible. But at any rate, I really didn't know what to expect with Tenet. Now, I'm a big fan of sci-fi films. I've always loved sci-fi. And at its core, Tenet to me is a sci-fi film. Now, it has all those espionage elements, kind of that big budget spy kind of feel, the Mission Impossible kind of scope and all that. But to me, at its core, it's a science fiction film that deals with time travel, inversion, multiple planes, and even dimensions and so on and so forth. So I was down for it. You know, I started watching the film. It was on a Saturday night. The movie's about 2 hours and 30 minutes long. And initially I saw that runtime and I was just like, wow, another 2 hour and 30 minute movie. But anyway, I decided to give it a watch. And I got to say, at the end of the day, I really enjoyed this film. I really did. I really liked the sci-fi elements in the movie. What impressed me the most about Tenet is that I've seen a shit ton of science fiction films. And even more than that, I've seen a lot of films that dealt, and television shows that dealt with time travel. And in general, basically, the time travel elements, while they may vary just a little bit, overall, they're basically the same. And what I admired about Tenet is that Christopher Nolan actually crafted a story that kind of turned time travel upside down. It was totally different. It was a different concept, at least as far as I've seen in film. That's not to say that maybe this hasn't been done or explored in another film, a foreign film, or even a novel, but first I've seen of it in a film. And I really thought that the structure and the crafting of the time travel elements were really impressive. It was something that I had not seen in a film. And I got to tell you guys, that is so rare today. It's so rare to actually sit back and watch something that does something different. And I really found it refreshing. And the fact that, you know, while this movie's going on, your brain is just ticking away trying to grasp what the hell you're watching. And it's a movie that always kind of keeps you trying to figure out what's going on. But I like the lead character. I liked, you know, the partnership with Robert Pattinson. I liked the structure of the story. Not one time that I feel bored. And like I said, guys, first and foremost, my first love in movies is science fiction. So I have a lot of patience when it comes to science fiction. I mean, you're looking at a guy who found Ad Astra entertaining and not boring, and I've heard horror stories about that film in terms of pacing. You're looking at a guy who loves Star Trek the Motion Picture, a film that even Star Trek fans don't like. But this film, I enjoyed it. You know, there was action in the movie, but I think that given the structure on how time travel is presented, I can definitely understand why a lot of people were turned off by this movie. This is just one of those films that you're either going to like or you're not going to like. And I think a lot of people that, maybe not a lot, but some people that say that they're bored by the film, I think it's probably just the structure of the story, the fact that you're dealing with an event, an inversion, as it's referred to in the film, and it is really hard to put your hand on. Sometimes it's hard to figure out what's going on in this movie. And there are still things that, you know, that I'm thinking about in this movie, and I did think about it. I've still thought about this film, but there are still things in it that, you know, you're thinking, how does that work? Would that work? And your brain wants to rationale and make it make sense. But a lot of it is there's things in the movie that that you really, you know, I won't say they don't make sense, because this is another person's story, and I'm sure to that person maybe it makes sense. But there's definitely this is definitely a science fiction film. There's elements in it that, you know, you just don't get immediately. And there's subtle hints as to what's going on. But, you know, overall, and at the end of the day, watching the film, and I watched it twice, because the first time after I watched it, I just felt like maybe I missed things. Maybe this wasn't explained, or maybe that was explained and I missed it. So I watched it again, and it was a lot clearer this time in terms of what's going on in the story. There are elements that were revealed, things about Robert Pattinson's character that, you know, isn't said in the film, but I pretty much figured out. The inversion of two people, one from present time, one from past time, and then you have the past moving backwards. And it's just I found it to be a really interesting concept. And if this is an original story that's never been done before, I got to give the director and the writer credit here. Christopher Nolan, he did a great job at creating this world. So at the end of the day, guys, I didn't get bored. I enjoyed it. It was almost like a viewing where I was just waiting to see what was happening next, because I just felt like the whole thing was really fascinating. That's the best word to describe my feelings for this movie. I was just fascinated, and I was to a point where I was just refreshed, thinking, oh, this is just something new. It's just something I haven't seen before, or at least it was a different take on something that I hadn't seen or I have seen before. So I enjoyed it, and so much so that, you know, I contacted my friend Jeff afterwards the next day, and I wanted to talk to him about the movie, and I said, hey man, have you seen Tenet yet? And he was like, no, I haven't seen that film. He said, but I've been meaning to watch it. And I said, well, you know, give it a shot, watch it, let me know what you thought about it. And the next day, you know, we got together and we discussed the film, and he loved it just like I did. But, you know, Jeff and I are he's my brother from another mother. We both love science fiction, and he really enjoyed the story. And it's interesting how, you know, he interpreted some things that I didn't pick up on, and I picked up on things that he didn't pick up on. But you know, we're sitting there talking about it, and I'm just like, yeah, you know, that's right. Yeah, I didn't think about that. But it's a film that is food for the brain, makes you think, and it involved me in the story. I loved the lead actor, who was actually Denzel Washington's son. I think he did a great job, great character. Acting's really good. Production values are really good. And I enjoyed it. I really enjoyed Tenet. I think it's a film that, you know, I could return to and even watch again. But, you know, like I said, it's not going to be a movie that everyone's going to like. That's for damn sure. But I enjoyed Tenet. I really did. And I think it would have been one hell of an experience to see in the theater. So at any rate, guys and girls, that's my thought on the film. I don't want to spoil it for those of you who haven't seen it. I would say if you are thinking about watching it and you're not a fan of science fiction or time travel or any elements like that, it's probably not going to be your piece of cake. The pacing, I wouldn't call the pacing slow, but it is a long film. I didn't really feel like, and I even asked my friend, did this feel like 2.5 hours? And he said no. If I think about recent movies, say Wonder Woman, Tenet is a classic. I mean, it's 2.5 hours to me well spent in this story. There's a little bit of indulgence, I would say, maybe a few scenes that didn't need to be in there. But, you know, that's always a point of view. I'm sure that Nolan felt like this needed to be in the story to enhance it. But overall, guys, I got to say, I really enjoyed Tenet. I really did. Best film I've seen in a long time. Some of you may be surprised at that. But yeah, best film I've seen in a very long time. But it's not going to be for everybody. Thanks for watching, everybody. Take care of yourselves, and I'll see you in the very next video.